I wanted to step a few more steps through Aperture, show you Aperture. Aperture is kind of a photo organizing system. I have albums and photos and all kinds of stuff. So I pick photos, you know, from my main photos. I can hold my command or Apple key down and click on the photos that I like and drag them into an album. For example, I like these, this one here, that one, and I can drag them into the collection. I make an album by going to the plus sign, create an album, give it a name, test 201, that shows up here on the bottom. Then I go into my albums and just collect and start dragging and dropping into the album that I want all my photos to be in, that I want to do a slideshow on. So I already did some into my collection. And here I do command A for select all, right click, and do new slideshow. So here you can name it. Gomez collection. And here you can also choose the themes. Classic is just kind of a dissolve between. Ken Burns zooms in, or origami kind of folds and flips it over. Vintage is similar to iPhoto. Sliding is similar to iPhoto. But unfortunately, iPhoto does not have scrapbook, and that's what the theme you liked. So I can choose that. And down here on the bottom is my slideshow. You can change that. Gomez photo collection. You can set it for, you know, your computer monitor. If you're doing it on a TV, you will choose TV, HDTV. You know, you can make it a little longer, like it have 10 seconds, kind of gives it a little more flow, and you can pay attention to it. It doesn't go by too fast. Then you play with your timeline. You can move the photos, you know, around. I like this one to be here, you know, that one to be there. So, you know, to get the right flow, or if you, you know, how you're timing it. You know, you can put text, you know, Golden Gate. Third. Day, you know, the Hecla saves first step. So she's kind of not right in the photo, so you can actually click on the photo and drag it or zoom in to adjust them, and you can do that to almost any photo wherever you are. And I want to see that car, or move that waterfall over a little bit. So you have options to clean it up a little bit. And frame them. You know. Gullfoss. It's one of the Icelandic waterfalls. Gullfoss in ice. I'm not sure, I can probably custom. No, okay, customize it. Gullfoss in ice. Yeah, you can change the font. But I was thinking if you can replace, you know, if you can, I guess you can just put space before it and get it in the middle. I don't want two of them here, so I delete one by hitting delete. So, you know, you kind of got some options to play with that. Okay, this framing is off, so you want to, you know, try to frame it better. Hello. Why is it not doing that? All right, let's go back to the slideshow. Should be able to frame it. Maybe I need to just move it around here. Get a different picture there. There you go. Brent Rogers, move him around a little. Let's keep going somewhere else. Okay, maybe I need to use my up and down arrows for it to work. Anyway, there's a little tweaking you can do here and there. So there's a lot of options you can do in it. But when you're done, you hit export. You say, okay, I want the 10 of the best TV size, 1080p, where you want to look, you know, save it to. Another thing you might want to do is here in the settings, and that's repeat slideshow, so it kind of loops it. You can, if you want to add music to it, then you go to your Apples or your music, and I pick a song that is not maybe popular on iTunes, so it can. It won't block it, and the green line would be the music, so we'll follow the music. Oh, here I can put another song. Oops, that was a lot of music right there. Pick something really old from Iceland, so I don't know where. Why do you keep doing that? I'm doing it too fast. Here we go. So there's another song, so you can add music to it as well. You know, so if I do preview. And the other song is here somewhere. Þetta er lítið lag um fiðrild og flugur og frækorn og smugur. So if you want to have music in it, you can do that as well. But this was just kind of a little preview on Aperture and their theme of a slideshow.